Welcome everyone to this short demo video from the NG-CDI project. In this demo video, we are going to describe the design of our intent capturing system, and we're going to demonstrate how our system can capture and execute business intent over an emulated BT topology. Before describing the concept of our system, it is worth first reminding our viewers what is network configuration and how intent-based network systems can simplify it. Network configuration is effectively the process of defining to the individual devices of the underlying network infrastructure how they should process network traffic in order to deliver high-value network services. Mechanisms to define configuration have evolved over the years, and IBN is one of the most recent paradigms. Traditionally, the way that network infrastructures were configured was achieved via the network administrator. A network administrator would collect requirements from end users, and then, using pen and paper, and given his knowledge of the underlying infrastructure, would design effective per-device configuration files that they would allow the system to meet the desired goals. The underlying configuration files would contain statements like the one shown here, which would define precisely for each device how traffic should be forwarded based on the content of the different packet header fields. As you can imagine, this process has two major challenges. First of all, the network administrator becomes a big bottleneck since all requirements have to be manually processed by them. And in parallel, the distributed nature of network configuration in traditional network systems introduces a potential challenge for misconfiguration. As networks grow in size in order to cope with the increasing networking demands of end users, these challenges become major and they affect the responsiveness in fulfilling customer requirements. More recent efforts have tried to explore how human involvement can be reduced when defining individual configurations. This is typically done by vendors which introduce in their configuration languages the ability to define statements that can adapt the resulting policy depending on the network conditions. Effectively, users can use statements like if statements, which they can inspect specific measurable metrics of the network. And when these metrics hit specific thresholds, they can adapt the policy in order to fulfill a backup policy expression. These approaches, they significantly improve the bottleneck that occurs because of the human involvement of the network administrator. But they still require from the network administrator to explicitly define all possible scenarios, and they still operate in a highly distributed fashion. Intent-based network management tries to address both of the aforementioned challenges by decoupling the actual goals of the network from the resulting configuration. Effectively, network administrators as well as end users can access intent systems and express their functional goals. An intelligent system would then process the input from the users and network administrators, and given the current condition of the network, it would define an updated policy that would meet the requirements of the end users. Example of statements in an intent-based networking would look more like this, where the user would just need to define the conditions that need to always be true in a network. In our system, we explore how modern conversational interfaces can help users to reduce the ambiguity in the expressed intents. This technology is highly important, as it can unlock true automation from the network. A significant amount of processes inside an ISP rely on human-to-machine interfaces, which currently are not easily automated. By exploring the design and the models required to support new interfaces, we have a gold opportunity to identify the type of interactions that occur between users and systems, and at a later stage, we can explore also opportunities for automation. In parallel with our work on this demo, we also try to explore a new model for intents that would allow a network operator to automate the process of management intents. Existing intent systems that are predominantly focused on capturing network configuration and service connectivity requirements, we want to explore how this can go beyond traditional network service intents. For our system design, we have opted for a distributed system based on Microsoft design principle, and we try to reuse existing open source projects in order to improve and enable a smart intent capturing system on top of our intent manager. Specifically, we allow users to interact with our intent layer through popular chat services like Telegram and Google Assistant. In order to analyze user input, we use an off-the-shelf open service from Google, which is called Dialogflow, which allow developers to specify interaction scenario with users, and it automates the process of processing human spoken language into actual statements for applications. The output from the dialogue service is processed by a standalone service which uses normal conversational mechanisms to describe to the user what has been captured by our dialogue flow layer and engage in a discussion that would allow the user to clarify any ambiguity in their expression and try to express precisely the required network intents. Once the user and our intent capturing system can converge to the correct intent expression, the intent is then pushed into an intent management layer, which contains several drivers that allow our system to translate high-level user intents into the required configuration on underlying subsystems, like the service orchestration layer through the OSM system, and the underlying programmable network through the ONOS operating system. In parallel, our system uses feedback from the underlying infrastructure management systems to report the state of the intents to the user, which can help him later on to refine the expression of their intents. For the rest now of this demo, I'm going to describe the topology used and the technologies used to realize this demo, and we're going to see some of our intents in action. For this demonstration, we're going to use a mininet to emulate a topology for an SDN network that resembles the topology of the 21CN BT network. All switches are programmed as open flow switches, and we have also incorporated at this point here a legacy Cisco router, a 7200 router, which runs on top of Dynamips and emulates legacy devices in a programmable infrastructure. In order to control now our topology, we're using ONOS, an open source network operating system that allows basic programmability of networking devices across an infrastructure. On top of ONOS, we have created, and Mininet, we have created a small application which can be used to control traffic between different endpoints. In our scenario, we're going to use the iPerf bandwidth estimation tool to generate steady-state TCP flows between pairs of end hosts towards a server. Alongside now our mini topology, we also have connected a virtualized compute server, which basically resembles the compute resource in a programmable infrastructure. On this compute server, we have deployed an NFV mechanism using the MANO standards, and our network service is able to connect and reconfigure the legacy device using the telnet protocol. In order now to interact with our service, we are using the Telegram application, and we have built a dedicated Telegram bot which can be used to perform some basic operations through our intent layer. As then provides some basic help, and it provides support for three basic intents. The first intent, which we call traffic reroute, allows a user to effectively drain traffic from a specific switch device and reroute traffic through alternative paths. This is an intent that can be used by a site engineer, for example, in order to drain traffic from a device that needs to be upgraded. Using this intent, the site engineer can skip the requirement to negotiate with the network administrator in order to adapt the overall network topology. In order now to run this command, we simply have to use an intent to express our requirements. So in this case, we're going to pick two hosts, host 6 and host 9. They currently are using the path S6, S11, S14, and using our intent, we're going to redirect traffic to go via switches S6, S17, and S14, I'm sorry. So, once we submit our request, the system will describe to us the intent, and once we confirm, then the updated intent will be deployed in the network. A second now intent that our system supports is the ability to control to define service protection periods for the infrastructure. This intent allows manager staff to effectively forbid any possible reconfiguration on the underlying infrastructure, a feature especially important when you have major events where the QoS, the delivery of QoS to end users, is critical. Now, in this case here, we are going to update our time, and our system will describe what we have just asked the system, and in a few minutes we can trial and see if actually the system will work. So in this case, I'm going to trial to reroute traffic between 86 and 89, and instead of going via router 17, we're going to ask the system to reroute traffic through through switch 11. So once we hit enter, the system will again ask us if we can confirm the deployment of the service, but in this case we will see that the deployment will fail because the service protection is activated. Our final intent, which is called router upgrade, is designed to simplify the management requirements of an account manager in a network operator. A router upgrade allows a user to request the upgrade of the capacity of a link of a specific device, router device, in order to improve the connectivity of a specific client to the network. In this demo, we are going to upgrade one of the interfaces on the router 10.0.0.10, and that's the interface towards the switch S17. This currently is at 100 megs and we're going to upgrade it into a 1 gig. Obviously this upgrade is emulated and we're effectively using intents to automate the process at the software level. So we're going to issue now the intent that describes all the required details. The system will describe to us that in order to achieve that there is a required change on the path of an existing intent and then followed by the actual upgrade of the interface. And as the upgrade goes on, the system will notify us about the process of the upgrade. So now, as you can see here, the path has switched to another path which doesn't contain the upgraded router. The upgrade has been performed via the OSM layer and the system will report to us the UUID of the operation. And finally, a test is performed, a ping test, to ensure that the new path has been actually deployed. So once the test succeeds, then the system can report back to us with the outcome. So wrapping up this presentation, in this demo we have tried to present how the adoption of novel conversational interfaces can simplify the expression of intents from non-technical users. In parallel, also, we have shown how we can build an intent manager which can support some very useful network management intents. This demo was built by myself, Harris Rotsos, and Ben Sims. And you can find the source code for the demo as well as in our intent manager repository at the organization NG-CDI on GitHub. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed this demo.